Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Aditya Gupta. Welcome to the series and this topic of USMLE and how to prepare for USMLE, step one, step two, how to match and everything. I again have with me Dr. Prakash Gupta. He scored 258 on step one and an excellent score. And in this video, we'll discuss about the resources that he used, the books that he used, specifically covering the second prof. And we'll be discussing about those books, which will be good from the INI CET or NEET PG aspect as well. Especially this is the emphasis there, as they improve your clinical understanding of the subject. So if you're someone who is, suppose you're someone who's confused, you are on the crossroads, ki you want to do Indian PG, tumhe AIIMS mein jana hai, whether you want to come into pursue Indian PG or you want to be like Prakash, you want to go to US. But these books are going to be helpful in both the scenarios. I'll again emphasize, Prakash, rank kitni thi yaar? NEET India, sorry, AIIMS mein teri, NICT mein?
NICT mein 384 thi.
Yeah, so again, him and another student, batchmate of mine, they scored rank 80. What I want to emphasize is, even if you prepare from a USMLE point of view, definitely going to be beneficial and you can still score a really good rank if your concepts and understanding of medical subjects is good. So we'll discuss the second prof subjects this time. We'll begin with pathology. So what resource did you use, Prakash, to score this amazing score of 258? And as we all know, pathology forms a major chunk of step one examination. So what were the resources that you used?
Yes, so pathology is like the most important subject on step one. And I used two main resources. One of them is Pathoma and one is Golgan. So Pathoma is both videos as well as textbook. So Pathoma textbook is like 250 pages and Pathoma videos, they are like short and simple and it only covers the most important aspects of the exam. So if you're short on time, you can just watch Pathoma videos along with the Pathoma textbook and it covers pretty much everything that you need on step one. So Golgan,
this is the book Golgan.
Yeah, so we'll talk about,
this is a rather old edition which I used for my preparation, although it did not be my step one, but I was using it in my second prof. Golgan, I'll elaborate on Golgan further, because as Prakash said, Pathoma is for people who are short on time, who want a very crisp review, but it will cover most of the things that are asked in your USMLE step one. They are really good videos by Dr. Hussain Sattar, I think. You know, just 250 pages covers everything along with first aid, obviously. But if you have time on your hand, if you're starting your preparation back from the second prof itself, Golgan is a really good book. There are other editions now, but it is slightly thick book, 700 to 800 pages. So you need time on your hand. I read this book. It improves your clinical understanding, like I've told before. Robbins, along with this books, if you do have time, this can improve your clinical understanding of a paraclinical subject and hence being important, both from your USMLE and your NEET PG or INICET aspect. So pathology, the two resources are, first, Prakash.
First is Pathoma and second is Golgan. And I want to add something about Golgan. So Golgan is like a big book. And like if you're short on time, it's difficult to read that. But for someone who is still in their second professional year or someone who is between like, who is in their third year, so this book is like a bridging book between pathology and your clinical years. So one problem that students face is like in their second year, they're not able to grasp the clinical concepts when they start going to their clinical postings. So this book can bridge that knowledge gap and help you better grasp the concepts both for pathology as well as when you start going to wards and OPDs.
So next subject, I'm sorry. I'm again sorry. The next subject that we're going to cover is pharmacology. The bane of every medical student, everybody hates it. Although pharmacology is just, I have said in my previous videos, just physiology amplified or tuned down. So we'll discuss pharmacology in three aspects. At the forefront, I say if you're someone who's preparing for NEET PG or INICET, Dr. GRG's book is an excellent book, especially for INICET and NEET PG. But the resources for the USMLE, if you want to score as high as Prakash, 258 or even higher than that, for that matter of fact, the resource that you need to use is, what did you use, Prakash?
So I mainly used Kaplan videos and Kaplan notes.
Kaplan, so, which were the, who was the doctor? I've already elaborated on that.
So Dr. Lionel Raymond has like I think 80% of the videos in pharmacology in Kaplan, and they are like really great videos for concept building, which is like a bit like not up to the mark in Indian author books. So like you can use Kaplan during your second professional examinations also.
Even if you're preparing for your professional examinations right now, Kaplan,
yes,
videos, especially Dr. Raymond videos, even I use them. They were excellent. I will again re-emphasize Dr. Raymond videos, especially the 2010 or 2014 Kaplan videos that are there. They're excellent to prepare for pharmacology, especially from the concept building. He's an excellent teacher. And as far as a book or the resource that you need to read, the big book that we are talking about, I think everyone knows it. Even Prakash read it. It's which one?
Buddy Katzen. Big Katzen.
Big Katzen.
So yeah, this book.
So this is a book that even I sometimes read. The problem with this book is that it's there. It's huge. You need time. But if you want someone want to spend time on building your basic good concepts in pharmacology, Big Katzen is the book to use. But if you're someone who's preparing for USMLE, if you're someone who's preparing in a 6 month time or a 7 month time for the step one, what is the book that you use, Prakash?
You can use the review of the Big Katzen, which is the Katzen review. It is a much smaller book and it has MCQs also.
Yeah. So this is the Katzen review that Prakash is talking about. So you can use this to in your prepping up time of the 6 months period. If
yes,
you're preparing for USMLE step one. So pharmacology, I'll sum up and Prakash will agree with me. For concept building, you have to use which books, which videos?
So Kaplan videos and Kaplan notes.
Yeah. That is Dr. Lionel Raymond again.
Dr. Lionel Raymond. Yes. Very important.
Very important. If you have time, if you're beginning from the beginning, you want to emphasize your notes, the Moti Katzen.
Moti Katzen
is the one you can use. And if you're short on time and you're preparing for step one in 6 months time, then the pharma review.
Moti Katzen.
Moti Katzen,
yeah,
is the one that you can use. Last subject, microbiology. Again, something that almost every medical student doesn't like or is confused where to read or what to read. Now, microbiology as a subject can be divided into three major aspects: virology, immunology, along with bacteriology and mycology. So we'll cover these simultaneously. For virology, what was the resource that you used, Prakash?
So specifically for virology, you can use Javits Microbiology and you can use Levinson's Microbiology, which is a foreign author book, and it is very good. So it covers most of the concepts of virology.
And as far as USMLE per se is concerned, what were the resources that you used?
So for USMLE, you can use two main resources. One is Sketchy videos. And so Sketchy basically creates an elaborate visual from a daily life scenario, and it adds intricate details to those videos, which can help you. And then it like correlates those details with the details of a particular microorganism, and it helps you remember better. So, but I have seen like a lot of my colleagues don't like, they're not super into the videos. Some people like them, some people don't like them. So in case you don't like them, you can use a book. It has a really long name. It's called Clinical Microbiology Made Ridiculously Simple. So this is the book that Aditya is showing in the video. So this book has some like funny cartoons to elaborate like the microbiology concepts, and it correlates very well clinically.
Funny cartoons.
Yeah. So Aditya is showing one of the cartoons from the book. So it is a really simple and fun book. And even if you don't have very good concepts on microbiology, you can build them up by using this book.
So I'll sum up the entire thing for these subjects. Pathology. Short on time, use Pathoma videos and lectures. If you are half time, you want something bridging resource, a better book, Galgen. Pharmacology, if you have enough time, 1.5 years, aram se pharma padni hai, the Moti Katzen. Short on time, Choti Katzen, but at the same point of time, irrespective of time, please watch Lionel Raymond videos. Everyone will recommend them. Microbiology, you can use Sketchy Micro. Some people can like them, some can not like them. Clinical Microbiology Made Ridiculously Simple is another good book for your step one preparation. At the same point of time, if you're someone who's preparing just for your NEET PG and you want concepts for virology as an USMLE author book, you can use Levinson or Javits. Levinson is slightly compact, more time saving. Javits is more detailed. So this will
Yes.
sum up the video of what resources you can use. These are the resources you can decide for yourself. And these are resources which we did not get, out of our mind. And suddenly, हम लोगों को किसी ने, ऐसे अचानक से हम लोगों को पता नहीं चल गया. We did not get them in our dreams or something. As I have elaborated, first, it is an excellent book for both USMLE and INICT or NEET PG preparation. In the end of the first set, all these books, name of these books are given. And at the same point of time, the review of these books in the form of their scoring in A, B or C is given. We're just elaborating on that. So,
So we are basically listing like the highest yield books which exist on second year subjects. And these are given at the back of first aid as well as very high yield resources.
Whether you want to be like Prakash and go to US, scores 258 in STEM, or you want to be someone who comes to AIMS or, crack INICT or NEET PG. Irrespective, if you're confused, doesn't matter. If you are someone who is going for USMLE or INICT, these are the books that can be helpful in either of the preparation.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Prakash, for being with me today again. Shalom. All right. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thanks for having me.